He'll watch a movie, then he'll tell you all about it. It's the Armstrong Entertainment Show.
Hello everyone, and welcome to Armstrong Entertainment. This is Chad here, and I saw the movie Ex Machina. Now, let me first start off by saying I am so sorry I've been gone for so long, but there's so many crappy movies out right now that I haven't been seeing anything. And this is my first movie I've seen in a really, really long time. So let's just jump right into it. This movie is about a young programmer who works for like a Google type company. And the CEO has this contest where he selects one of his employees to win this prize, where he's basically going to introduce him to this machine that he has created that's an AI, artificial intelligence machine. And basically, he wants this employee, this young man, gets selected, and he has to do all these tests on her to make sure she passes and she's a good enough AI. So that's basically the premise of the story. Now, I think you should go into this movie knowing the least amount of information as possible, because the less you know, the more into it you'll be. I literally was questioning everything I was seeing, because you can just tell there's something a little bit more going on than what you're led to believe. Oscar Isaac stars as the CEO of the company, and he is incredible. I love this guy. He's in Inside Llewyn Davis. He's going to be in the new Star Wars movie. I thought he was incredible, and I loved his character. I don't want to give anything away, but this movie just really surpassed my expectations. I was recommended this movie by a friend. Actually, a few people had been recommending it to me, and I was dying to see it, and it definitely lived up to my expectations. But I don't want to build it up too much, because maybe somebody won't like it, but it's amazing. As soon as this film started, I was instantly invested. There's really only four major characters, and it's so interesting how this movie with only four characters held my attention more so than most movies with like 50 characters. It's that good. It's one of those movies you're watching and you're thinking, okay, something's not right. There's a hole there. I thought that they made a few mistakes in the film, and I was like, oh gosh, this wouldn't be happening the way it's happening. And then all of a sudden at the very end of the film, they explain a lot and you're like, oh, that's why that doesn't add up. I don't want to give anything away, so I'm being so vague. But the ending of this movie, I love the ending. I thought it was a great ending. Some people are going to say it's kind of open-ended and it's left into interpretation, but I don't believe it was. I think it was a very clear decision of what happened. And when you see this film, I'm dying to talk to people about this film and get their take of what happened. Because I know what happened. I know exactly what happened. I need to stop hyping this movie so much, because I feel like your expectations are going to be so high going in. But I would think a lot of people would like this film. It's very clever. I'm just going to say it. It's in my top 10 movies of 2015 already. That and Kingsman. I have two in my top 10 already. So definitely I would say check out Ex Machina. It's not Ex Machina. It is Ex Machina. Yeah, I promise you'll like it. I promise you like it. Go check it out. It's playing in the theater near you. Until next time.
He'll watch a movie, then he'll tell you all about it. It's the Armstrong Entertainment Show.